Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the Cathedral of St. Matthew the Apostle. My name is Tom Staley. I'm the Pastoral Associate for Liturgy and the Director of Music Ministries here at the Cathedral. I want to welcome all of you who are here in person and who are joining us on the live stream. On behalf of our rector, who is with us today, Monsignor Jameson, we're so pleased to have you help us to celebrate the completion of this wonderful, lively Fulcher organ, which was liturgically dedicated in May, almost 2 years ago, and then in a concert dedication with Nathan Lauba in September of 2019. And of course, like many places, we closed the recitals there last spring, but we were able to reopen, and we've been having recitals since September of this current season. So we're coming to the end of this, but we're so delighted to have Ronald Stolk with us to help us celebrate this Eastertide recital. Ronald is the director of music at the historic St. Patrick's Church downtown. He is a former associate here at the Cathedral. He is also a lecturer in organ at Catholic University, and originally from the Netherlands. He has been a former dean of the Washington, D.C. chapter of the AGO, I think twice, and also a former board member of the National Association of Pastoral Musicians local chapter. So he's been extremely generous, not only with his talent and his wonderful personality, and but also with his time and building up the music community and helping to train other musicians and giving advice. Speaking of which, I had the great pleasure of working with Ronald on two papal masses. It's kind of rare that a Catholic musician gets to work on one papal mass, but both he and I worked on the 2008 papal mass at National Stadium with Pope Benedict, and the papal mass in 2015. He was the organist for both of those papal masses, so we were really pleased to be able to work together at that time. The program for today is not printed. We are not printing during COVID times, but if you go to the YouTube channel for the Cathedral, just go to the Cathedral website, you can find on the opening page of the YouTube stream a copy of the program. Ronald will speak twice during the concert, so you'll hear more about the pieces, but if you'd like to follow along, you may do so there. We are accepting donations, if you'd like. All of these concerts have their costs and the fees, and so if you can assist us with that, we can keep doing this for another season. We have an exciting announcement about the next concert. It will be live stream only because it's already been recorded, but we're going to be airing five segments of a recital starting May 17th. Nathan Lauba, who dedicated the instrument in 2019, has already recorded five pieces for a recital which will be brought out on a daily basis in the week of May 17th, and it'll come out one piece a day, so you can take a morsel and enjoy that and then wait for another drop the next day. So watch for more information on that with the pieces. Well, you've come to hear him, not me, so let us warmly welcome our guest today, Ronald Stolk.
Thank you. That was to begin with a piece by Johann Sebastian Bach, Alla, Breve. It reminds you perhaps in Leipzig, where Bach worked for so many years, there's a big concert hall and it has a Latin inscription, Res Severa Gaudium Verum, a serious thing is true joy. So I'm sure this would qualify as serious. Two other composers who also worked in Leipzig, Max Reger and Felix Mendelssohn, wrote organ music too. I think it's very serious as well, but in a very different vein. Max Reger, in his 20s, wrote one gigantic organ piece after another, but also a great number of smaller, quite attractive pieces, of which I will play Romanze. That doesn't sound very organ-like, but you will hear it. And then a sonata by Felix Mendelssohn-Bartholdy. Mendelssohn never had a position as an organist, but was very famous as a Bach player and improviser, especially in England. He wrote six sonatas that were published all at the same time in London, in Paris, in Berlin, and in Milan. So a truly international production. You will hear number four, consists of four movements. Thank you. So now, after the Leipzig people and their serious joy, we descend into the area of guilty pleasures with this little piece by César Franck. Franck wrote this piece in the 1850s. That was before he was appointed to the Church of Santa Clotilde in Paris, where he would write his most famous organ pieces. This little piece is an andantino. It's the first published organ piece by Franck. It was published in 1857. And of course, it was meant to be played in church, where else? After this slightly worldly excursion, we get all serious again with a Dutch composer, Hendrik Andriessen, who wrote a beautiful Sonata da Chiesa, church sonata. It's theme and variations and a pretty exuberant finale.
Thank you.
As if that weren't enough. Now, what some of you have come to hear, in addition to all that, an improvisation. So here we are in a Roman Catholic cathedral in the season of Eastertide. So, earlier today, for the first time in a number of weeks, the Pope opened the windows of the Apostolic Palace and led the prayer, at that time in this season, a Marian antiphon. And that Marian antiphon is going to be the source of the improvisation today. The Regina Caeli dates back to about 1200. It's found in antiphonary of in Rome. It would usually be sung at the end of Compline, but during the Easter season, it replaces the Angelus. So, interestingly, not only are there two Roman references here, but there's a third Roman reference because in Jacobus de Vargine's 13th century golden legend, the source in that legend is a procession to pray for the end of a plague in Rome. And Pope Gregory the Great is said to have added a fourth line of a chant, being this chant, of course this is a legend, and then upon adding that fourth line of this chant, the angel on top of what we'd think of as Castel San Angelo sheathed his sword or her sword to indicate the end of the plague. So, let's hope that we're celebrating Easter and the end of a plague as we listen to an improvisation on Regina Caeli. Now, for those of you who do not know the tune, first of all, the text is Queen of Heaven, rejoice, alleluia. The one you merited to bring to birth rose from the dead, as he said, alleluia. Pray for us to God, alleluia. And the tune is this.
Regina Caeli, laetare, alleluia, qui aquem meruisti portare, alleluia, resurrexit, sicut dixit, alleluia, ora pro nobis Deum, alleluia.